Dear students, now I am going to take question number, Roman number 3. Roman number 3. So, here it is given that 10 theta by 1 minus cot theta plus cot theta by 1 minus 10 theta. We have to show it as equal to 1 plus sec theta into cosec theta. So, we need the answer in sec theta and cosec theta. 1 plus sec theta into cosec theta. We have to show it as. So, first we will convert 10 cot into sine and cos. That is our first work. So you can see, I have written 10 theta as sine by cos, then cot theta as cos by sine, here cot theta cos by sine, here 10 theta as sine by cos. Now we simplify the denominator part. So you see now here, sine by cos, and here it is, LCM is sine, so sine into 1 is sine minus cos, and here the LCM is cos, cos into 1, cos minus sine. So now you see here, this denominator, they are different. So sine into cos, it will become sine cos. So see this step now. See here, this sine, I have written sine by cos, this ratio, this is divide sign. And we have put it as multiplication sign, conversion of this divide sign into multiplication sign. Then this whole thing will become a reciprocal. Now this sine will go up. So sine divided by sine minus cos. The same way here. So cos by sine, multiplied by, this is divide sign, it is converted into sign. So then cos minus sign by cos will become cos by cos minus sign. Here was no space, so I have written here. So now see here, sine into sine is sine square, cos into, then this whole thing, sine minus cos, this whole thing, sine minus cos, plus, then here cos into cos is cos square, then here it is sine into cos minus sine, up to here you understood, students? So now, nicely, we could take the LCM easily. Some of the terms are almost similar here. Just you see, here it is cos, but it is here sine here. But this binomial part, you see, this binomial, sine minus cos. But here it is cos minus sine. Only the difference in the order. Here first comes sine, and here next cos. Here it is sine, cos first, then sine. So we can change this order. Like, suppose B minus A is there. You want to change the order of it. You want to write first A, then B. Then how to change? Keep the minus sign here and keep a minus sign here. Because A was negative, as the bracket will be open, A will become again negative, B will become positive. So, just you think that way. Hope you will understand this step now. See, as I told you here, it is sine minus cos, and but it is cos minus sine. I want to make it sine minus cos. So, if I change the order inside the bracket, then sine will come here minus cos. Then for that change, I have to keep a minus sign in front, because as I will open the bracket, it should be again cos minus sine only. So why we are doing like this? Because same sine minus cos is here also, sine minus cos. So at the time of simplification, this will be a great help for us now, because same factor is appearing in both the denominators place. Same factor has appeared. So we can take the LCM easily. Suppose you have got A by B, C. And minus, suppose you have got here D by B E. Then in LCM of this B C B E, what will be in the LCM? B is common, so B will be only one time. Then C and E are uncommon, so C and E also will come here. You understand this part? How to take the LCM from this type of expressions? These are called algebraical expressions. From their LCM, we can take the like this. The common factor only once in the LCM, and the uncommons everything. So the same thing we will do there also. See here. So it is cos, and this is sine minus cos, and here it is sine minus cos. So sine minus cos part is common. This is common. So that will come only one time in the LCM, but cos and sine both will come, because cos and sine are uncommon factors. So here now, sine square by cos into sine minus cos, and this minus sign has appeared, because already you have seen, here was this minus sign and this was plus sign. So if this minus sign is taken to the numerator side, this minus will affect this plus sign, minus into plus, minus. So that's why you can see here minus sign now. So now LCM from these two denominators, cos into sine minus cos, sine into sine minus cos. So cos and sine are uncommon factors, they will come, and sine minus cos is common factor, so it will come only once. Now how to take out the factors from here? by dividing by this expression, this numerator, this denominator, you divide this denominator. So you will get the factor like this. Cos is here, cos is here, don't take. Sin minus cos is here, sin minus cos is here, you don't take that. What was not here, which is here, that you have to take as a factor to multiply with this upper numerator. So what I'm saying, cos is cancelled, think like this, cos is cancelled, sin minus cos also is cancelled because it is here, then you have got sin. So this sin you have to multiply with this numerator. That means sin theta into sin square theta will give us what? Sin cube theta. Sin cube theta. Minus. Same way, this sin and this sin you think that they are cancelled. Ignore it. Then sin minus cos, ignore them. Then what is there left out? Cos. And that cos you multiply with cos square, it will become cos cube theta because it is already cos and this is cos square. Cos square into cos is cos cube theta. So it is appearing like the algebraical identity a cube minus b cube. So now we can apply a cube minus b cube formula here. So we are applying here a cube minus b cube formula, a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square. You remember a cube minus b cube formula? In algebra you got factorized form of a cube minus b cube. This formula, a cube minus b cube, this formula. That is a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square. That form. So that way it is a sine minus cos, sine square plus sine into cos plus cos square. And the denominator is same. So now you see this sine minus cos factor and this sine minus cos factor, both can be cancelled out. So at the end, what we have? We have got sine square plus cos square, that is equal to 1. So we can write here 1 plus sine into cos, sine theta into cos theta. So sine square plus cos square, that is equal to 1 plus sine theta into cos theta divided by sine theta into cos theta. Now if you separate this, no, this part by this denominator, this part by this denominator, like suppose you have got a plus b by c, then you can separately write as a by c plus b by c, yes or no? So that we will separate these two also. So students, here we got 1 plus sine into cos by sine by sine into cos. So now separating this, 1 by sine into cos plus sine cos by sine into cos. Now this sine cancel, cos cancel, so it will be equal to 1. So this two, this whole thing can be separately written like this, 1 on sine theta into 1 on cos theta, because 1 into 1 is 1 only. Writing this way, the beneficial thing is that 1 by sine is cosec theta, 1 by cos is sec theta, the required expression, plus 1 here. So ultimately we got here 1 plus cosec into sec. So 1 plus cosec into sec, this is the result proved.